Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick coming to you from just outside Area 51 in Nevada, also known as China Lake, whatever it is, Groom Lake. Anyway, brothers and sisters, staying at this place. It's real cheap. It's supposed to be, well, it's in the middle of nowhere, but I just found out that there's all these tour buses of Chinese coming from LA, Japanese and Chinese coming here and staying all around us, and they keep yelling at each other in Chinese real loud and banging on all the doors. So just having fun, always. And there's no power outlet in here. You have to unplug like the TV to charge the computer, which is also unique about staying in the middle of nowhere. You know, you get what you pay for, brothers and sisters. Anyway, God bless all you guys. I just been out running around outside, and I didn't even realize that we were so close to Area 51. I was outside doing my jogging, and then, you know, the Lord just, you know, told me, hey, you're right here at Area 51. And so when I came and looked on the computer, it's true. Anyway, brothers and sisters, I just talk about that, even though, you know, lots of you brothers and sisters are conspiracy people, and lots of you are not. And it's not really about conspiracy. It's just actually where the U.S. military does their engineering aircraft. And I just wanted to say this about the place. There's the American military doing their advancement in air and flight aerospace technology. But there's lots of people who are allegedly whistleblowers from there. And one of them I heard, you know, they could be fake or whatever. Who knows? Anybody can come forward as a anonymous, you know, whistleblower, and it could just be a bunch of junk. There's crazy people. But I heard one guy give his testimony, and what he said was, is that he was a test pilot at Area 51 for the U.S. Air Force. And because, see, they fly out from Las Vegas. They live in Las Vegas. They fly out there on Monday morning and then fly back, you know, late Friday night or whatever, Thursday night or something. The employees there at Area 51. And which is a real place. Some of you, you know, that are really got your head in the sand, because the employees tried to sue the government because their exposure to, you know, chemical waste and all this had made people sick, and then the government didn't allow them to sue. I don't think it was. But anyway, it was, you know, the Area 51 is a place that the government, I think, they finally recognized that it's a real place, I think, through that court case. But anyway, it's a real place. It's called Groom Lake or China Lake, and then Area 51, whatever. This man was a test pilot there, and what he said was, and I believe him, you know, he became born again Christian. And he, after he got born again, he went back to his job. He flew out there on the Monday morning in the middle of the night flight or whatever it is. They fly out in the middle of the night from the airport in Las Vegas. He landed out there, and when he went to do his job, what happened is that his the people that he was working with, some of them were supposed to be aliens. He said that the person that was training him to fly this new technology, like a UFO, you know, like this, like the stealth technology and all that, was an alien who spoke to him telepathically. And you know, you hear all these people saying that they speak to them telepathically. So what happened is he became born again, and he went back out there the next week, and then guess what? He saw those aliens, that they were really demons. He could see them. He wasn't any more blinded or deceived, and he saw them for what they really were. They were demons. And so this brother, you know, he as best as he could control himself, he said that he was sick and all this. He had to leave and get back, get out of there, and he did. And he didn't say another word. He quit. And I heard him give his testimony. I can't remember if it was on Coast to Coast AM. I think it was. He was on there telling his story. And that is a believable story, in the fact that this man was, you know, witnessing that he became born again, and he testified he was a Christian. So even though it could also be fake, there's lots of crazy people, like I say. Area 51 could just be our military doing their technology. But there is evidence about, let me just talk about this. I never really talked about it too much, I don't think. Way back when I used to make my videos connecting, you know, at these MUFON, which is the mutual whatever, about the, someone's trying to call me. There's never ending, brothers and sisters. That's why I try not to give out the number too much. the MUFON, which is the Mutual Whatever UFO Network, people who've been abducted and all this, they have organization. And in the past, it's been non-Christian. It's your New Age. Lots of them are New Age wacky people. Okay, but now the MUFON stuff, they allow, like Dr. Tom Horn, they allow Christian speakers to speak. You can see their conferences on YouTube of Christian people speaking to this UFO societies. And what they're doing is what like what the Lord gave me the revelation. You know, independent of any of these people, I discovered some of these people's testimonies after the Lord had already showed me independently by His Spirit in prayer and study that these aliens are in actuality demons. And some of them are even fallen angels. And I've made videos, there's a difference between demons and fallen angels. And this is the difference. Demons are the disembodied spirits of the giants. And then they try to possess people. Fallen angels are, of course, are angels who fell. And they're some of them are bound, as the Bible says, because someone always just knows a few Bible verses. They'll say, well, aren't they bound? Some of them under the rivers, Euphrates, some of them are in the abyss. Yes, and they will be released in the end times, yes. But there's also powers and principalities and forces of darkness in high places, you know, in the second heaven. So some of them are bound and some of them are loose, like Satan now. Satan is not in hell now. Satan is loose. He's the prince and power of the air. He's the god of this world, the Bible says. And until the Lord returns, Satan is the god of this of the prince and power of the air. Jesus even said that he was the god of this world, the prince of this world. In the Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus said the prince of this world comes and have no part of him. You know, and so Jesus has defeated Satan spiritually, and we have victory over Satan as individuals, as part of the church. But when Jesus returns to rule and reign on earth, He'll remove sin from the earth and remove Satan's authority that he has over the lost right now. Satan has authority over this world, over the fallen world, and over people that are not Christians. They're, as the Bible tells us, see, that's why lots of people, they get confused. They keep talking about everybody's a child of God. No, we're all creations of God. We're all creatures. And then it says in John chapter 1, Jesus gives us the power to become the children of God. The Bible tells us that God translated us from the kingdom of darkness. When we get saved, we are translated from the kingdom of darkness to the kingdom of His dear Son, Jesus Christ. I believe that's in Colossians. Or Colossians, or I think that's, anyway, brothers and sisters, I can't remember everyone all the time. All the Bible verses. You can Google it, look it up on eSword, you can see where it is. Because I'm thinking it might be in Titus. But anyway, brothers and sisters, this world is the enemy's world. So there's nothing that should surprise you. And lots of people are way over in the conspiracy world, and they get caught up in what the devil's doing and the devil's people, like the Henry Kissinger, the Bilderbergers, the Illuminati, all that stuff. But the Illuminati is just a manifestation of their god, Lucifer. He's the light bearer. Lucifer means light bearer. He's the one, you know, like the torch of the Statue of Liberty. That is the illumination of Satan, that, you know, if you eat this fruit of the knowledge of good and evil, this Gnosticism, then you will be like God. That's the lie of Satan from Genesis. That'll be the lie of the Antichrist when he says, hey, take my mark, worship me or my in my image, and then you will be like God. We'll have our own paradise here on earth. We don't need God. We can make our own Garden of Eden right here. When you take my mark, you'll be part of my utopia. That's why communism, if you go look, brothers and sisters, and go study, you will see that communism, you know, really, we're talking about Marxism, Karl Marx, was a disciple of a leader of the Illuminati. I forgot the name right now off the top of my head. He was discipled by the Illuminati. Darwinism, you know, evolution. Darwin was a fourth generation inbred. Now that's where they get all this idea of the survival of the fittest. All these rich Illuminati elitists, they believe they keep inbreeding with each other that they'll become perfect. But in reality, we know when people inbreed, they become handicapped. They become crippled and mentally, you know, deficient in all this. And they become freaks. That's what happens with inbreeding. But these guys, they think that's what it is. That's where they come up with the whole theory. As a matter of fact, there's an uncle. It's either the uncle or the grandfather of Charles Darwin. I haven't looked at this in a while. He wrote a book way before Charles Darwin really laying out. Charles Darwin really just took the ideas of his, it was either his uncle or his grandfather who already had a published book and ran with it. But it all comes down to this. It's racism. It's the manifest destiny. It's this, you know, superiority of these blue bloods, brothers and sisters. That all comes from the Nephilim, the half humans, half fallen angels in the past, back in those days. That's where all this idea about the royalty of Europe, the royalty of the world, they're all inbred. The royalties of Europe now, They can trace their bloodlines all the way back through the Caesars, all the way back to the ancient Egyptians, and even to the Babylonians, all the way back to Nimrod. The same bloodline is there. What they talk about in the Da Vinci Code, the bloodline of the of what they're trying to say, the natural children of Jesus, is actually the children that will the Antichrist will come from. The same blue bloods. Think about it, blue blood. You know, you're talking just like if you see the movie of William Wallace and all that, Robert the Bruce and the Mel Gibson movie, you see they put that blue paint on their face. It's this trying to look like a reptilian. You know, what is a reptile? Reptilian, a snake, a dragon, Satan, and the fallen angels and demons. They look like what people talk about, the aliens. That is like a snake with just a bigger head. It's like a snake with a little body on it. That's what the people are seeing, brothers and sisters. That's why they talk about blue bloods. Yeah, reptilian blood. Not, you know, think about that. There's an origin of all of these things, brothers and sisters. It all goes back to Babylon, the Tower of Babel, the ancient mystery religions. There is nothing new under the sun, as King Solomon said in Ecclesiastes. This new age is really the old age lies straight from Genesis chapter 3, when Satan told Adam and Eve, when you eat the fruit, you will become like God. That's where it all leads to, brothers and sisters. That's where the deception always goes to, that you're your own God. You don't need God because you're your own God. That is the greatest deception. That's what it always goes to. You follow that trail, you will see where it leads all the way. It will lead to the culmination of Satan's kingdom, the Antichrist, brothers and sisters. So all of these things, some of it's true, some of it's not true about Area 51, all these things about the U.S. government and different governments working with the aliens to try to do this and do that. There's some truth to all that stuff, brothers and sisters. But then again, it doesn't matter. That's the problem. That's what I'm trying to tell you. There's those of you who get off into this wacky stuff like Steve Quayle. Go look him up. Wacky to the point of just believe everything. And just, you know, it's just, been proclaiming that the sky's fallen for 30 years. And then on the other end, there's some of you brothers and sisters that don't believe anything. You laugh when someone says, oh, I saw a UFO or whatever. Listen, brothers and sisters, we have to have the answers. We have to have a unified theory. And the unified theory is that, yes, there's millions of people that have seen UFOs. We have to give an answer to them. We can't stick our head in the sand. We have to say, yes, you saw something. Well, guess what? You probably saw a demon that's trying to deceive you and trick you away from the Lord. Yes, you saw something. You can't tell people you didn't see anything when they did. That's what's keeping several people in this world, maybe thousands or hundreds of thousands, from becoming born again. Just like Darwinism. We need to address it and not say, well, the Bible doesn't really say, and maybe the Bible's not literal when it talks about creation. No, brothers and sisters, you have to go look at the evidence and see that the world was literally created in 6 days. 6 days. All you have to do is go follow the science, the real science, and not the hype, and go study all this stuff, the fossil record they claim. Go look at the fossil record. You will see that it shows and proves creation. Creationinthe21stcentury.com. You want to go there? There's outlines of debates of creationism versus evolution, and go read it. And I don't like to get into that too much, brothers and sisters. You know why? Because I'm not going to spend all my time debating with someone who is a God hater that will not get saved when I can evangelize and win 1,000 people to the Lord that are just kind of open to the Lord. Because the devil's people, mockers of God, will take up all your time. So even though I can run circles around individuals, because God has given me the wisdom and I've studied it to talk and debate about evolution, and I've done seminars on evolution in the Philippines at colleges, college campuses, and to groups of pastoral students. But when you start talking to these God haters, I don't care, as the Lord has put it in my heart, there are people on earth that's never heard the gospel. And until they've heard the gospel, I'm not going to go beg somebody that's heard the gospel all their life to please stop hating on God when they know in their heart better. And they're looking for excuses and justification to live in sin. Just as the famous brother who's one of the smartest men that ever lived, Ravi Zacharias, you can go listen to his stuff. You'll hear something good about philosophy and Christianity. Ravi Zacharias said the atheists do not have an intellectual problem with God. They have a moral problem with God. You start talking to people and getting to the heart of the matter, cut to the chase, you will find out they really believe in God, but they just don't want to submit. They want to be the captain of their own destiny, and they do not want to submit to God. Now, that is the ultimate root of the problem with all rebellious people who've heard the gospel, who know better. They will waste your time and run you in circles and try to make you look like a clown and make you look ignorant when it comes to talking evolution and all that. That's why you need to know your information, just so you can, hey, give them a good strike and let them know that you're not a chump and that they can't outwit you. But it's not about those things. As the Bible says, God will give you a tongue that cannot be gainsaid against. In other words, the devil's people can't outdo you, because God's anointing on you will give you the words of wisdom to say, that they cannot gainsay you, as the King James word. They can't gain wisdom over you through talking. That's when the Spirit of God comes in, not just memorizing like a robot some text, brothers and sisters. That's the difference. You have to be led by the Spirit. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you guys. By the grace of God, that things will be quiet around here. It seems that, you know, the enemy always has a way to try to mess with you, right? But praise the Lord, they're quiet right now while I'm making the video most of the time. God bless you guys. I just want to thank all the brothers and sisters who helped with Joshua's ministry. And I don't know yet if we have enough. Some people have donated. I don't know yet. I've got to see if I've got enough that's come in to buy the truck. We're getting pretty close to buy the truck. Not sure yet, brothers and sisters. I'll let you know when I've got enough. But I really will wait till I get back to the Philippines and go down there and see for myself and check it out, make sure it's good. And I have some friends. I have several Filipinos I know who are mechanics and stuff. Get them to check it out, make sure that it's good and that we have the money in, and we'll get it. And I'll keep you guys posted on that. I appreciate all those who are helping us to buy the vehicle. And the, you know, the increased cost, as we have doubled the amount of orphans, you know, every orphan is, you know, it's like basically say $50 more a month. So, you know, we have more obligation now, and it'll take more budget. And as I'm coming to the States and starting the Church of the Firstborn and going around by the grace of God to do crusades and revivals at churches to bring a wake-up call to the dead Laodicean American church, you know, I know that God will provide. And that, brothers and sisters, that the Lord will continue to make a way for me to minister to all those who watch my videos. I have many more people to give a word to. I've been giving people personal words who's asked me just now. It's like a season. God works in seasons, brothers and sisters. I had several people that the Lord had me to private message them a word. You know, it just goes that way. But, I've been working on the list. I'll say, you know, I got about, I'm down to about 25 names right now. So praise the Lord for that. Still working on it. I'll make a video by the grace of God, maybe even tonight, you know, for tomorrow morning, maybe, of the rest of Word of Wisdom for people. I'll try to work on that tonight by the grace of God. God bless you guys, and I'll be back on here later. God bless.